Welcome back. It's still the 7 to 8 breakfast show, and we have somebody in the house. This is Asanwa.
Oh, beauty queen.
Omali Chanwa.
Egovin.
This is Nwabeke.
Like pretty woman.
Hey,
the those ones that people, even boys, you see and say, beg them.
The time that you pay their bride price in dollars. This type, the inflation cannot make you, cannot pay it in naira. We're talking serious. And it's not this one that's here that's doing ice cream. It's not, she's not the one I'm hyping. It's not Joy Nice I'm hyping here as I'm talking. When I say Mwabeke, say, ah, maybe he's talking about Joy Nice. No. We have Miss NGO 2015 in the house. The beautiful. Oh, girl, she's so lovely. I mean, just look at her. Just look at her.
She's pretty.
It's Ijeoma Okafor on the show. It's great to have you. You're welcome.
Thank you.
You're welcome. You're the idea of what I call a beauty queen. Not all those people that they are so skinny. They're even skinnier than my own beauty queen here.
We just
have to. It's great to have you. It's all about you now. It's about you. You're welcome. Great to have you on the show.
All right. Thank you very, very much.
All right. So, you were studying banking and finance, and you are a beauty queen. How come it wasn't an art-related course? Maybe I was thinking maybe theater arts or something like that. Why banking and finance?
I started modeling last year, 2015. I took it as a career because I've been doing modeling from my secondary school. And when I got to SS1, and then I was going to the science side, been in my mind was like, I want to be a doctor. So when I entered SS1, and then I saw the chemistry, biology, physics.
You
were
scary.
It was so scary and difficult. So I had to divert to the art side. And then I started contesting for my secondary school where I did Miss Inter Sports. So I won. It gave me that inspiration and all that to venture into modeling. So that is how it started.
She was a doctor and I've been 6:30.
Yes.
I just come into the hospital.
Like, I want that female doctor, that one. That
please, is Dr. Ijeoma around? Thank you, I'm okay. I'm okay, let's leave this hospital today.
Thank you. Okay. I just feel like you hold like two titles, your Miss NGO Nigeria.
Yes.
And then there's another one, your face of your school, most beautiful girl in Madonna University. I know you're also looking forward to contesting.
Yes.
For another one.
Yes, that's the Face of Nigeria
Face of Nigeria World 2016. You still have a crown as it is.
Yes, I do.
The organizers of Miss NGO, don't they have anything against you competing while still?
Not really, because I'll be handing over this November.
That's
why I was given that privilege to contest in another pageant. Yeah.
Okay, the clarification of viewers out there, there's the face, when you say Face of NGO and all of that, I say that the only criteria is your face. Don't they look at the body like they do in order, or is it just the face?
Okay.
What's the criteria?
Not really, but the face matters.
Oh, okay, yeah. The face matters.
Yes, the face matters a lot.
You cannot be looking like, what's the name of that South?
You cannot be looking like Mike.
That's Sudanese. Is it Alekwe?
Okay, Alekwe, yeah.
You know, these are one of these poor models, they look at their body, their face.
Mind you, Alekwe is the highest paid black model in the world.
Yes,
Changed.
But she's not that.
She's not at all.
Pretty at
not
all.
Not that. Remove the that. She's not.
Yeah, that's right. Okay, so then, what is the criteria for selecting the blessed face of.
Face of Nigeria. Yes. All right, the face matters. And also, what they actually look at is your assets. Yeah, the way your intelligence too matters a lot. So they're not really looking at the body stature and all that. So what matters is the face, how intelligent you are, how you can face people out there, and how you can market the brand too.
So how well have you worked towards marketing the brand?
The brand, exactly.
The face of NGO.
Okay, I'm actually contesting, so I hope if I win, I would try everything within my capacity.
Okay.
To
do you have any plans to go into any full blown out beauty pageant? Ones that you wear night dresses, you wear bikinis and all of that. The full pageant. Do you have any plans to go into stuff like that?
Okay, after this, my next target is MBGM.
Hey!
Let's do this quickly.
Let's imagine.
Okay, manager, we don't want you here. Okay, so now this is our.
Ladies and gentlemen,
this is Miss World Pageant. Excuse me. Like, this is your national, like, this is a global TV.
This is the first one. The manager has to come out.
No. Manager, please. What do you think? Okay, right now. We have here on stage with us contestant 16. Of course, you know it is Miss World Pageant 2017. Okay, so give us your acceptance speech when you become Miss World. We just want to hear your acceptance speech. You've won. You have your crown. You're Miss World, and I'm like your sister, and I'm like, oh my God, my sister just won. Okay,
your
so sister. Please do us proud.
Your sister. Your presenter. Just choose one.
I am presenter.
Okay, so ask her.
You just won the biggest crown any mother would want to win.
Okay. Yes. If I should win, my acceptance speech should go like this. Hello, everybody.
Yeah.
Thank you for the opportunity of having this crown. Obviously, it's not easy. I mean, out of other contestants, an emerged winner. And I hope I'll use the last crown very well. Like, my 1 year, I'll make very good use of it.
Talk about me. I'm crying. I've been praying for you to win. Just say something about your sister
and
backstage.
And my sister, too. She always had my back.
Okay. I know you're having plans for MBGN. Mm-hmm. What exactly, Mal, I know, what exactly do you hope to do? Like, what do you expect? Let's say you're talking to somebody out there who also wants to be a beauty queen, who wants to participate. What kind of tips would you give a person in preparation? Okay. What kind of things do you do? Maybe diet, what do you eat, stuff like that?
Okay, I eat a lot actually, but it doesn't show.
What's your favorite food?
Okay, rice and plantain.
Yeah, that's what they do. Is it fried plantain or?
Yeah, fried plantain.
Okay, because some of us went to schools where they used to give us rice porridge and plantain. Yes, they do rice and yam.
Egg.
Don't mind us, Jerry.
Okay, so for me, I eat a lot and I also work out too. Yeah, I eat and I work out, so that's why it doesn't really show on me. There are some people that eat and then you see it all over their body.
Okay.
But it depends on you. You have to know the way your body is. And then working out is very important.
What's your workout routine like? Let's talk about your workout routine. What do you do in the morning when you wake up?
Every morning, at least I know I jog.
You jog?
Yeah, I jog. Wow. Even
you,
if I don't...
You jog also?
I don't jog like every day, but I do sit-ups and I do squats as well.
Okay. That's also good.
That's cool. Okay, so apart from jogging, what else do you do?
From jogging, and then I do sit-ups like you said.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right. That's about all. Do you use a jump rope and all of that?
Yeah.
Does that? Okay. Yes. So now, let's see. Now, she's the form queen in this place. And actually, you guys are wearing the same stuff, you know. But then she has plans. You know, she has plans to contest, but she doesn't know how to catwalk.
Yeah.
Okay. She doesn't know. I don't know. Okay, for the face, if you're doing a face off NGO contest, do you guys have to catwalk and all of that?
Yes, we do that.
Come on, teacher.
Come on, teacher. I do not want to do this, but Mike is shaming me right now.
Come on, teacher.
Can you help the young lady beside you?
Okay, come on, teacher. She wants to form. And both of you are wearing the same skirt.
I
feel like you're carrying yourself. No?
Okay,
so just teach her the catwalk in case she wants to. Let me just stay this side.
Like you're signing in.
Okay.
Yeah, where you bring this leg.
I know. Okay. Is this one on me? You see? I know.
Okay, you sign in.
Yeah.
Like this.
Like this.
Uh-huh. Okay. You smile. Then when you're ready to catwalk, you go with this leg first.
Okay.
So try, let's see.
No. I cannot catwalk.
No, try it now. How can you not catwalk with it, did you? Try it, Jare.
No. Go with
Camera.
Okay. Maybe you should show us.
You follow her. If she will not be
taken. I'll follow
her.
Okay,
let's go.
Let me try.
Okay. So. Go. Strike a pose. Turn. Yeah.
Show yourself.
Let's see right now.
I've closed the show. Rachel, you must catwalk today. Catwalk.
Why?
Okay, let us close the
Why?
Show.
Oh,
Madam,
goodness.
Catwalk there. Catwalk and talk, come round. What is this?
Oh no way, Mike.
Take
I'll pay you back. I'll pay you back with every.
But that was a good try.
It was a good try. You think so? Okay, that's
a good try. You see?
That's cool. Okay.
I mean you like today. Like, just get off my case.
You don't want to catch up. You want to catch up.
Get off my case. Yes. So when you were in the house, mm-hmm. when you got on set with other beautiful ladies, I'm sure there were beautiful ladies, yeah. hot, and you know, that also knew how to catwalk and all. What do you think made you stand out?
I think what made me stand out is actually my charisma. Yeah, my charisma, the way I carried myself, because there were lots of beautiful ladies there.
Finer than you?
Yes, of course.
How can you be able to find? I mean, look at this girl. You were finer than you?
Yeah, they were.
Are you sure?
Yeah.
Are you sure?
Yes. There are a lot of beautiful ladies there, and if you're not courageous, you get intimidated.
Aww.
Yeah, so one thing that keeps you going during camp is your charisma, the way you carry yourself, not looking at the kind of category of girls that are there. So that's it. And everything, time too, matters. You know, they have different times for different activities during camp. And keeping to those times a lot matters, because it makes them feel like when you're being called, you answer immediately.
Hmm. Yeah. Okay, now, see, what size are you, by the way?
Size 8.
Size?
Between a 6 and 8.
6 and 8.
I'm not a proper 8.
Choose one. I can't get 6,
ladies
7, 8. There are 2 sizes.
Struggle.
Choose one.
Why, Mike? Why are you doing this? You understand what I mean, right?
Okay, choose
one. I'm not 8. Okay. I'm in between 6 and 8.
6 and 8. What size
yes.
are you, dear?
Size of?
Body size.
Okay, body size, 6.
6?
6, 7.
And 8.
Yeah. See?
Joy, please, what size are you? What's your body size? 9.
42.
Is that okay? What's the required
Nine.
Body size for pageant? Is there a required body size?
Not really. There's not really a required body size rather.
Okay.
Because some pageants make use of the bigger size of people.
Yeah. yeah.
Okay, but what if it's MBGN? Is there a prerequisite body size for
slim.
MBGN?
Just slim.
So they don't give you body sizes and all of that.
No, they don't.
Okay,
no.
But now personally, I don't really bother the skinny girls so much. I love the way you look, but then I'm thinking that if you're going for MBGN, wouldn't someone say you're a bit too big?
Chubby.
Or chubby?
Really? Okay, except... I will save that for now because yeah. I'm on break and I've been eating a lot.
You've eaten a lot, right? You'll do some work out there.
Yeah,
because I would... You see, I'm now... The management has already started. So we'll just sign... After now, we'll just sign the contract for formalities. I'll be your manager and all that. Yeah, anybody I manage, I'm sure to win. So, but then... Okay, but then...
My.
What was the you? Okay, but you spoke out about before the MBGN. What are you planning to do to get yourself ready to win MBGN? Yeah.
Okay, nothing really. I just need to work on myself.
Okay.
That's all.
Okay. Now, what's the most important lesson you've learned after? Yeah. I mean, being a queen. Now, people look up to you. People see you as a model, somebody who's an icon or something. What has that experience taught you?
Okay. To me. Has taught me to be, number one, you have to be friendly.
Yeah. Are you serious?
Very, very friendly.
That's...
Because you don't know the person you meet today, where you're going to meet the person tomorrow.
Okay.
I mean, it has happened to me one time. Okay, in school, there was this guy I was rude to then in secondary school. Like,
okay.
I took him as, you know,
yeah.
only for me to go for my NGO, Miss NGO, yeah. and I saw him there, and he was our catwalk director.
How did you cope?
So, we coped well. You know, that was in the past, so we just had to pretend like nothing happened.
Nothing happened.
Yeah, how come he was catwalk director? That's interesting. Okay, but then apart from being friendly, what else have you learned?
Okay, another thing, you have to be up and doing.
Up and doing.
People out there are always looking out for you.
Wow.
Yeah, they're always looking out for you. And they were like, what does she have to do today? What does she have to do tomorrow?
Okay.
Yeah. Did you face any challenge in the house? The camp?
In camp, the only challenge I faced was during the games.
During the games,
they did. Like this one that you draw a rope.
I can imagine.
So those things I didn't do well.
Okay.
Most of the games,
and then I want to ask you this one, because I'm a model and I know what we face.
Okay.
Some models complain that most organizers of beauty pageants ask more than what the models can offer. Did you experience anything like that? You know what I mean, right?
Yeah,
asking for more than what you can offer as a model. Like they want to see you in their special room, you know? Because they want to teach you something and all.
Okay.
Yes,
I didn't experience that actually, because the pageant I went for was a junior one. You know, nowadays in Nigeria, there's so many pageants. You hear Miss Gold, you hear Miss Silver,
Miss
So there's
Miss
so
Bold
many.
And Beautiful. As in, yeah. of Lagos.
As in, there's so, just so many
there's
now.
There's so many, and someone will just wake up one morning and be like, let me invent my own pageant.
True that.
So before you go for any pageant, you have to make thorough investigation about it, so that you don't end up falling in the wrong hands.
I know what I'm asking, because I know a very big pageant app I cannot do myself. I cannot come up with a name right now. I can't say anything about the name, but I know that that is what they do. They tell you, like, they know you're winning, and then they'll be like, we want you something. They'll take you to see the governor or for special treatment. And the thing is, the ladies know. Like, when you ask them, they'll be like, oh, we know she's going to win. Because there's been this preferential. Yeah, they are project. I'm sure you know what I'm talking about. I don't think it's about knowing or knowing how long they've been organizing the pageant or any knowing anything about the pageant.
Okay. In that case, I'll answer the question like this.
Okay.
You know, one thing in Nigeria, it's either is money, either you pay in cash or you pay in kind. So to me, I'll be able to answer
which
the
one
question.
Which one do you pay?
It's cash, my dear. Cash is better. Yeah, because when they feel you have the money, they give you that respect.
Yeah.
But when you give them that the money is not there, that's when they start looking at the other way. So once you know you have the money, just pay them in cash.
Okay, now, I don't know whether is it a requisite that every queen has to have some sort of a pet project?
Yes.
Is it by force you must have projects?
Yes, no. Yeah. What do you do with your crown for 1 year?
What? I want to use my crown to go to Bora Bora. I'll be chilling with Jimmy and all them rest. I'll be snapping pictures. I want to do. Do you have to have a pet project?
Yes. For
okay,
beautiful,
so what was yours?
You have to have a pet project. Like mine was mostly the IDPs.
IDPs? What did you do?
I visited them in Abuja.
Okay.
I gave them items, gift items, things that they need.
So you have to have, right?
Yes, you do.
Okay, and then looking at it now, after the whole process, and now you're looking at giving for relinquishing the crown on when? November?
Yes, November.
When is the event happening?
I think November 21st.
Okay. That's when you're going to relinquish it?
Yes.
Okay, that's when you're relinquishing the crown. Okay, now in 1 year, if you wanted to, giving up the crown, what would you tell the upcoming queen? What would you tell that queen? Relinquishing the crown, what would you tell the queen?
I would tell her to keep pushing the crown and the brand too.
And the brand?
Yes, because once she can't push the crown, definitely the brand will fall.
Fail.
Mm.
Fall.
Well, did you win any prize? What was the prize for winning?
It was a car.
Did they give you your car?
Did they give you your car?
Yes.
How many months after the pageant did they give you the car?
That was after 6 months.
Okay, I think that's like the normal time because they have to sign a lot of things and all.
To make sure that after
6 months?
Yes, I know.
6 months?
Yes.
Uh-huh. You can even go for 3 or 4 other pages in that term now.
Exactly. Okay, so during the competition, I know there's a stage where they tell you to perform a talent. You either sing, dance, or what did you do?
I danced.
Yeah.
You show yourself
today. What's your thing?
What's your favorite song? What's your favorite song? What's that song when you hear? That you jump over and go, what's the song?
Any hip-hop song.
Okay, but you're going to do a Nigerian dance for us. Any Nigerian
Rachel,
dance
for us.
Rachel, you will show her. But okay, you want me to dance with you.
She knows that you got it.
Okay.
So what Nigerian dance will you do for us then?
Any Nigerian dance.
Okay, so
that,
people.
We'll round up with that, right? We'll round up with that. Okay.
Okay. Before you go, how can people reach you on social media?
Okay.
Facebook, Instagram, Twitter.
On Facebook, I have an official page on Facebook, Ijeoma Okafor, and then my private page too, Ijeoma Okafor too, and then on Instagram at Queen Ijeoma Okafor.
And, we need to move that queen to Facebook and Twitter also.
Let me just sound like hello right now. Okay, so guys, this is our show for you today. We have a beauty queen here with us, and she's going to be taking us out. She's going to be doing a Nigerian dance. And you know how I did on the show. Basically, what we're doing is entertain you. So tomorrow, we're going to be at same time on the same station, R2TV. But before we leave today, she is going to take us out with a Nigerian dance. I cannot wait for this one.
You will show us how to do it. Because if it's me that wants to show you, you will not be able to dance my own dance room.
So she's going to dance.
So she will show you. Yeah.
Oh,
you
want me to dance with you?
Yes, yeah, dance with you.
Okay.
You will not be able to dance my own dance room.
Now.
Wait, where is the song? Let's hear the song. Let's hear the song.
Say love is a beautiful thing. Can you dey cool my temper? Love is a wonderful, tender feeling. You dey give me. So baby, dance it, dance it, dance it. The beauty in your eyes, they give me life. Oh, oh, I could give the love the thanks. Oh, for the sake, for the sake of love. Oh, baby, leave it, I'm a diva, double. I'm a diva, double, I'm a diva, double. short. For your sake, I go touch you.